Good morning, everyone. Myself Deeksha Anand, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, AJIT, Mangalore. So in this video lecture class, we'll be studying about Module 5 in Concrete Technology. So that is about ready-mix concrete. And whatever the datas or the topics I'll be discussing in this class, you can refer in the notes from page number 1 to page number 7. And some of the topics we are going to include in this ready-mix concrete. So that is manufacture and requirement as per QCI RMCPS. And its properties, advantages and disadvantages, self-compacting concrete and its concept, material and what are the tests on ready-mix concrete, application and typical mixed fiber reinforced concrete, that is FRC, and fiber types, properties, application of FRC, lightweight concrete. In the same way, so we will be discussing so some of the topics under the full module, that is module 5. So moving on to the topic or the contents. So first we'll what is ready mix concrete. So far we have studied, so as we recall from module 1, so in module 1 we have studied about the ingredients of the concrete and ingredients of the concrete, and after knowing what are the ingredients of the concrete, we have studied about the fresh concrete, then about hardened concrete, and in module 4 we'll be studying about the mixed design. So before moving on to the module 4, we'll study what you mean by ready mix concrete and what are its properties. So now what do you understand by ready mix concrete, and in short we can call ready mix concrete as RMC. So the concrete whose constituents were weighed according to the proportion at a central batching plant, mixed either at a plant itself or in a truck mixers, and then transported to the construction site and delivered in a condition ready to use, is termed as ready mix concrete. So if we go for a small manufacture of a concrete, so we'll be doing hand mixing, and in the site itself we'll be mixing or we'll be batching all the materials required for the manufacture of the concrete, and then we'll use that concrete for that particular construction work. But in case of ready mix concrete, so where this ready mix concrete will be used, or when we go for this ready mix concrete, so whenever we require a large quantity of concrete, so we'll be going for central batching plant, and then we'll be transporting that in the truck mixed. So some of the materials, so that can be mixed in the plant itself or in the batching plant, or it can be transported or it can be taken to the truck mixers and then transported to the construction site. And during this transportation period, so transportation will not be for a shorter distance, so it may be for a longer distance. So at this point of view, like number of rotation will be given for this truck. So some of the topics about this we have studied in the hardened concrete. So why we give rotation for the truck mixers, because if you are not giving this rotation, these ingredients what we have placed in the truck mixers, so get or it get hardened. So to avoid this hardening of the concrete, so continuous rotation or the mixing should be taken place so that the hydration process continues. So when the hydration process stops, the cement or the concrete get hardened. So to avoid that, so the continuous mixing should be done and delivered in a condition ready to use is termed as ready mixed concrete, or we call that as RMC. So the concrete delivered at the site or into purchaser vehicle in the plastic condition. So plastic condition is not nothing but, so it is not in the hardened state. So it just takes the condition or the state of crumbling. So it requires no further treatment before being in position in which it has to set and harden is called as problems involved in the site mixed concrete. So the problems involved in the site mixed concrete. So whatever the concrete, we mix it in the site. So it requires large space to stack the materials and it requires large labor force. Work output will be low. So as we go for site mix, that is nothing but so either using a mixer, a concrete mixers, or by using hand. And the quality will not be uniform. And no control on water or cement ratio, variation of the mixing time, dust pollution and noise pollution. So these are the problems that involve in the site mixed concrete. So not in the central batching plant. So wherever like for us a smaller construction at the required place, if we mix the concrete, so these are the problem that occurs. Is what are the problem rectified by RMC. So the problem which overcome, so when if you go for, so what is the difference between the site mixed concrete as well as RMC. So the problem solved by RMC, so production by weigh batch, controlled mixing. So controlled mixing is nothing but so we'll be going, so in the central batching plant, so we'll go according to the mix design, and the water cement ratio can be controlled easily. Lower labor force and less maintenance cost. So since if we batch the material, if we take it into the plant, it will give the mixture automatically, so that labor force will be, the labor required will be less and less maintenance cost, and no need of ordering the cement and aggregate, reduces inventory expenses, multi transporting of the material is eliminated, assured uniform quality of the concrete, and pollution free environment. So there will be no noise, there will be no dust pollution, so that pollution free environment. Advantages of RMC. So if we go on listing out the what are the advantages of the RMC, so first one is production by weigh batching. So we have studied in production or the manufacture of the concrete, so there are the several types. So in that, first one is batching. In batching, we have studied about weigh batching as well as volume batching. But in case of production of the concrete, so weigh batching usually we are going to adopt. So production is by weigh batching. So in this type of batching, the properties can be controlled, same for successive mixing. And next is about controlled mixing. In plant, we can control the mixing without leading into segregation. So segregation is nothing but separation of the particle. So without leading into segregation, we can control the mixing. And water cement ratio can be controlled easily, lower labor force and less supervisory cost. So no need of ordering the cement and the aggregate. So since concrete is directly available for placing where it is necessary, reduces inventory expenses, and multi-transporting of the material is eliminated, and assured uniform quality of the concrete. So we'll get the homogeneous concrete, or assured uniform quality of the concrete will be available, and pollution-free environment, and time is very much saved than other modes of concreting. What are the disadvantages of RMC, ready mix concrete? So installation of the plant. So what are the disadvantages? Like installation of the plant has got high expenses when compared to other modes of concreting. So here when we go for the site mixed concrete, like expense will be less, because if we place it on a level ground where the water absorbent of all the material is very less, we can place or we can batch the material and we can mix it. But here in case of RMC, installation of the plant, it require a large place as well as the expenses will be high when compared to other modes of concreting. And legal complications near the location of the plant, and it is not suitable for small quantity of the concrete. For small quantity of the concrete, RMC is not suitable. So as I told you, so for we'll opt the ready mix concrete for the large quantity of the concrete. Next is, what are the classification of the RMC, ready mix concrete? So RMC is classified based on the place where concrete is going to mix. And it has classified into three types, namely centrally mixed concrete, truck mixed concrete, and shrink mixed concrete. So we'll discuss one by one. So what do you mean by centrally mixed concrete, truck mixed concrete, and shrink mixed concrete? So what is centrally mixed concrete? So in this type of mixing, concrete is mixed in the central plant, transported in trucks where it is required, and in this we can control water cement ratio effectively, but there is a risk of segregation that takes place while transporting. So we should take a small care of the segregation that should not take place while transporting. And in this type of mixing, a time requirement is comparatively more when compared to other type of mixing. So since we are going to transport the concrete, so time requirement is comparatively more when compared to other type of. Next is truck mixed concrete, second one, the second type of, second classification of RMC. So truck mixed concrete is nothing but a mixer will be mounted over a truck. In this type, mixing all the material is placed in the mixer tank and is mixed while transporting. And why this mixing is done? Just to avoid the setting time of the concrete. And in this type of mixing, time is saved very much when compared to above method. And hence here, water cement ratio cannot be controlled effectively and segregation do not take place. So why segregation do not take place? Because there will be continuous movement for all the ingredients of the concrete inside the mixer where it is mounted over the truck. Next is the third one, that is shrink mixed concrete. The concrete is partially mixed at the central plant in order to increase the capacity of the agitator truck. Agitator truck is nothing but where the truck is rotating, or you call it as a rotating mixer, and the mixing is completed in an agitator. And in RMC plant, it is necessary to control the setting time. So setting time has to increase either by adding the super plasticizers or by keeping in agitation till it is placed. So by adding, so super plasticizers is nothing but water reducing agent. So we can control the setting time by adding the super plasticizers or plasticizers, or by keeping in agitation till it is placed. So it should be. So now, what are the difference between the site mixed concrete as well as ready mix concrete? So we will get a question like to differentiate between the site mixed concrete as well as ready mix concrete. So some of the topics, so we have discussed in the previous slides about the site mixed concrete and ready mix concrete, but in this slide you can see the clear comparison. So the first one, that is quality is not uniform in case of site mixed concrete. So since we are going to mix it in hand, we cannot get a homogeneous, we'll try to get the mixture as a homogeneous mix, but it will not be uniform in case of site mixed. But It is assured uniform quality of the concrete in case of ready mix concrete, so that the continuous rotation will be given and each and every ingredients of the concrete will bind together, and no control over the water cement ratio in case of site mixed concrete. But in case of ready mix concrete, water cement ratio can be controlled. Here, inside mixed concrete, variation of the mixing time, and here controlled mixing. So controlled mixing will be given since we are going to mix it in a central batching plant, or like for this much time, like for a required time or specified time, number of rotation will be given, so that controlled mixing will be given in case of ready mix concrete. And it requires a large labor force inside mixed and requires a lower labor force. Site mixed concrete produces dust, but here there will be produces pollution. Ready mix concrete produces pollution, that is noise pollution, and produces pollution free environment. And here dust pollution as well as noise pollution, but some noise pollution we can see in the ready mix concrete, but since it is going to transport, we cannot hear the noise. But in the central batching plant, it may disturb the surrounding nearby the areas. It is economical and it is uneconomical because it is high expensive. Ready mix concrete is high expensive, and legal complications are not there, and legal complications will be there in case of RMC. Suitable for small quantity of concrete and not suitable for small quantity of concrete. So these are some of the difference between site mixed concrete as well as ready mix concrete. Next is manufacture of ready mix concrete, batching and mixing. So we have studied the manufacture of the normal concrete, that is batching, then mixing, transporting, placing and then finishing. But here in case of manufacture of ready mix concrete, so we will be having batching plus mixing. So at the start of production, so the dry material from the upper storage bins are discharged into the plant stationary central mixer, and then the proportion of the material is in the mix is custom designed to meet the specification of each project. So according to the project we have to design, or according to the grade we have to design the proportion of the material. And after proportioning it is controlled by computer to ensure the quality. So all the rotation or proportioning, it can be controlled by the system. And then the customer typically works with the ready mix concrete producers to determine the characteristics such as aggregate size, slump, air content and strength based on the intended use. The typical composition by volume is about 10-15% cement and 60-75% aggregate and 15-20% water. Entrained air bubbles may also account for 5-8%, and using less water generally results in a higher quality concrete. Here you can see the sand, aggregate, cement and water. So as I told you, like what should be the proportion, the typical composition by volume is about 10-15% cement, 60-75% of aggregate and 15-20% of water, and entrained air bubbles may also account 5-8%. So next is, so here you can see sand, aggregate, cement and water. So these are the ingredients of the concrete, so which are batched together according to the weight, and then mixing, and then it is quality test should be done, like quality of the material. Even here, after batching, we should go for the quality test of each and every ingredients of the concrete. Either it may be sand or it may be aggregate, cement and water. And then after mixing, finally, it is fed into the agitator truck. And next is transportation of the ready mixed concrete. So after mixing is complete, the mixture is discharged into a truck mounted rotating drum mixer. And rotating drum truck mixer typically have a capacity of, so what is the capacity of the mixer? That is 9 to 11 cubic yards, and discharge the concrete from the rail. And the slump loss can occur during the transit. It requires that the concrete be discharged on the job site within 90 minutes or before 300 revolutions after the addition of water to the cement. So admixture may be added to the concrete mix in the situation of the extreme temperature or long delivery times. So admixtures include air entraining agents, water reducing agents and set retarding agents. Vehicle maintenance is extremely important for ensuring the safe and efficient transport of the concrete products. Concrete plants typically include a full service garage to maintain their fleet of trucks. Next is placing of the ready-mix concrete, like where it should be placed and how it should be placed. So site should be kept ready to place. So after mixing, it is transported along with the mixing. So site should be kept ready to place the concrete as soon as the trucks arrives to the job. And less time taken to pour the concrete means the more time you will have to finish the concrete. And if possible, the easiest and the fastest way to place the concrete is directly from the truck chutes. So chutes you have seen in the hardened concrete, how it can be placed. So in the hardened concrete, during the transportation of the concrete, you have placing of the concrete, you have seen the method of chutes. So it can be placed directly from the truck chutes. And if you are placing concrete with the wheelbarrows, have at least 2 or 3 and strong men to handle them, because if you use only one, so it requires time. So if you have at least 2 or 3 wheelbarrows and strong men to handle them, placing can be handled easily. And if placing concrete on an incline, use a stiff mix and work up. So if you are using a lean mix on an incline, place and there will be a flow of the concrete, so that we have to use a stiff mix on an incline place. And pour the areas that require a stiff mix first. Add water in a later stage. Place the concrete in the form to their full depth and use a square shovel to clean the top of this. So to get a uniform or a plain concrete on the top of the top surface, use a square shovel to clean the top of the forms and lightly tamp the concrete need to form to make a sure all voids are filled. To avoid the voids, so usually to avoid the voids, we'll be going with the compaction, but here after filling, after placing the concrete, we have to just shake or to make sure or tamp or lightly tamp the concrete to make sure all voids are filled. And use the square shovel or concrete rack to keep the concrete level with the forms. Next is screed the concrete by placing a straight 2x4 on the top edge across the width of the concrete. Next, slightly tilt the 2x4 forward and pass it over the concrete in the back and forth sawing motion. And if excess concrete builds in front of screed board with a square shovel or rack, pulls the excess way. And if there are low areas, place the concrete in the voids and then re-screed over those areas. And it is important to screed each area 2 times. So screening levels and grade your slab in addition to helping consolidate the concrete. In order not to have any excess concrete, leave a small area or corner upon open until you are finished screeding and place any excess there. If needed, the truck can give you a small amount to complete the area. What are the methods of concreting? So methods of concreting, first one is concrete pumping, and methods of concrete, that is concrete pumping. So pumps are available in different size. So when we go for concrete pumping, so that is for lifting the concrete to the higher places, we go for concrete pumping. And there the water cement ratio will be more, or the water content, or it will be in the more liquid state. So pumps are available in different size. And pipe diameter must be at least 3 times greater than the maximum aggregate size it should be. So because there should be free movement of the aggregate inside the pipe, and a slump of 400 to 100 mm is generally recommended. What are the types of concrete pumps? So concrete pumps may be of different types. So direct acting concrete pump, or it may be modern concrete pumps, or truck mounted concrete pumps. So there are different types of concrete pumps, or a squeeze type of concrete pump. So first one, that is direct acting concrete pump. So you can see here a funnel and a pipe for the transportation of the concrete. So the concrete will be fed in the funnel and it will be transported through the pipe. So we'll see what do you mean by direct acting concrete pump. So it has a horizontal piston type with a semi-rotary valve. So horizontal piston with a semi-rotary valve, and concrete is fed by gravity and partially sucked during the suction stroke and moved up to 450 meter horizontally and 40 meter vertically. So using this direct acting concrete pump, it can be moved 450 meter horizontally and 40 meter vertically, and 60 cubic of concrete can be achieved per hour. You can see here in the next slide. So what are the properties or the description of the direct acting concrete pump? Horizontal piston with semi-rotary valves, concrete is fed by gravity and moved up to 450 meter horizontally, and 60 cubic of concrete can be achieved per hour. And the second type concrete pump, so you can see here vacuum pump chamber, and here you have a suction pipe and a collecting hopper. So suction pipe and a collecting hopper and the delivery pipe. So concrete is placed in the collecting hopper. So here, so we have a collecting hopper. So the concrete is fed in the collecting hopper. Used a small pipe. So using a small pipe of 100 mm dia, we have to feed a concrete in a collecting hopper. And the vacuum inside the chamber is about a 660 mm of Hg, that is mercury, and two rotating roller progressively squeeze the tube. So you can see here roller which squeeze the tube. So squeeze is nothing but compressing. You can see here it which squeeze the tube, and thus pump the concrete in the suction pipe towards the delivery pipe. So first what we have to do is we have to pour the concrete into the collecting hopper with the 660 mm of Hg, and here you can see rotating roller inside a vacuum pumping chamber, and which squeeze the pipe. So you can see here the suction pipe and the delivery pipe. So which sucks, so when these rotate, so it sucks the concrete from the collecting hopper and it collects the concrete in the pipe, and it goes and it discharges through the delivery pipe. So moved up to, so this concrete in this procedure, it can be moved up to 90 meter horizontally and 30 meter vertically, and 20 cubic of concrete can be achieved per. So these are the. Next is, what are the advantages of the squeeze type concrete pumps? So concrete can be delivered to the point over a wide area, otherwise not easily accessible. And pumping delivers the concrete direct from the mixer to the form and so avoids double handling. Placing can proceed at the rate of the output of the mixer, and it is not held back by the limitations of the transportations and the placing equipments. Limitations and the problem faced. So here, what are the limitations? That is, unsatisfactory concrete can be pumped. Control of mix is affordable by the force required to stir it in a hopper and by the pressure required to pump it. And placing and blockage. So here blockage can occur. So in this squeeze type, the blockage can occur. So water escape through the mix so that pressure is not transmitted to the solid. Therefore, cement cannot move. Therefore it cannot move. Or if the fines are very high, the friction resistance of the mix is so large that pressure exerted by the piston is not sufficient to move the concrete, which becomes stuck. These modern concrete pumps, the third one, the third type of concrete pump, that is modern concrete pump. And the first type of concrete pump is attached to the truck. It is known as a trailer mounted boom concrete. So what it is called as? It is called as trailer mounted boom concrete pump because it uses a remote controlled articulating robotic arm called a boom to place concrete with the pinpoint accuracy. And boom pumps are used on most of the large construction projects as they are capable of pumping at very high volume, and because of the labor saving nature of the placing boom. So they are revolutionary alternative to the truck mounted concrete pumps. And so the last one, that is the truck mounted pump. So here the second main type of concrete pump is either mounted on the truck or trailer and are called as truck mounted concrete pump, and it is commonly referred to as a line pump or trailer mounted concrete pump. And this pump requires steel or rubber concrete placing hoses to be manually attached to the outlet of the machine. Line pumps normally pump concrete at lower volume than boom pumps and smaller volume concrete placing applications. So these are some of the topics what we have discussed So these are some of the topics we have discussed in this video lecture class. And as I told in the beginning, whatever the notes I'll be sending, and in that module 5 notes you can refer from page number 1 to page number 7 for these topics what we have discussed in today's class. And the next topic is about self-curing concrete, so that one will be studying in the next video lecture class, that is part 2 of module 5. Thank you.